Good morning. Welcome to our city commission meeting, and we have Pastor Bill Sears from First Baptist Church. Good morning.
Thank you, ma'am. Let us pray. And Father, we thank you for the gift of a new day and for the privilege and honor it is to be able to live in a place like Panama City. And Father, we thank you for those who serve us. We'd be amiss if we didn't thank our firefighters and our first responders and our police officers who help protect us. Father, but we also thank you for those who diligently serve us, whether it's in these office areas or whether it's with our streets, our sanitation, our engineers, those who just help provide services to us to give us a quality of life, which is part of the privilege of living here. And Lord, we thank you for these who help provide leadership. And we just ask that this day that you would give them the wisdom to know what to do and then the courage to follow through and do it. Father, we thank you that as we can look at our lives, we know that we're either controlled by our smallest desires or our greatest aspiration. May we aspire to do great things because you've given us life. And we ask all of this in the sweet name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, Ms. Sackmeister, would you call the roll, please, ma'am?
Commissioner Rader.
Here.
Commissioner Nichols.
Here.
Commissioner Cady.
Here.
Commissioner Brown.
Here.
Mayor Brudnicki.
Here. We have the minutes from the March 22nd meeting. Everyone had a chance to read those ahead of time. And if there's any additions or deletions, so say at this time. Otherwise, entertain a motion to approve the minutes from March 22nd.
Mayor, I'd like to make the approval. Sorry, go ahead.
I'd like to make the motion.
Go ahead. I'll make a second. Yeah.
All right. Call the roll, please, ma'am.
Commissioner Rader.
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols.
Yes.
Commissioner Cady.
Yes.
Commissioner Brown.
Yes.
Mayor Brudnicki.
Yes. First things first, as soon as I cover all my wires up, we have a group here today from the telecommunications department. I'd like to have them stand. Very important proclamation to read. It would be like Harry Truman. Professional telecommunicators perform a critical function when an emergency occurs requiring police, fire, or ambulance, as well as those related to forestry and conservation operations, highway safety, rail, and air traffic, plus other services that affect the health and safety of our citizens. Thousands of dedicated telecommunicators daily serve the citizens of the United States by answering their calls for police, fire, and emergency medical services, and by dispatching the appropriate assistance as quickly as possible. Professional telecommunicators are critical to our city's emergency response and homeland security services, dispatching law enforcement, firefighters, emergency medical services, and other emergency responders 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Last year, our telecommunicators received 121,491 calls and dispatched 54,343 calls for police service, as well as completed 285,619 entries and transactions. Professional telecommunicators are not visible, as are the men and women who arrive on the scene of emergencies, but provide the vital link to public safety as part of the first responder team. Now, therefore, I, Greg Brudnicki, by the virtue of the authority vested in me, as the mayor of the city of Panama City, Florida, do hereby proclaim April 10th through the 16th as National Public Safety Telecommunicators Week throughout the city of Panama City, and in honor and recognition of our telecommunicators and the vital contributions they make to the safety and well-being of our citizens. Thank you.
Great.
They have a very tough job. And you notice most of them are women. I'm just saying. All right, next we have a presentation by Peggy Caldwell of the Florida Department of Health in Bay County for Students Against Tobacco. I guess we don't. Okay, at this time we have audience participation. Anything that is not on the agenda today, please step forward.
Good morning, Mr. Mayor, City Commission, Mr. Brown, Mr. Zimmerman, and Ms. Hochmeister. I know I'm going to say that wrong every time I come up here. The Children's Burn Camp in North Florida, also known as Camp Amigo, exists to provide kids who have physical and emotional scars from burns a place to be themselves and build a network of support that will last throughout their lives. The camp is fully funded by private donations, and campers stay free of charge. The camp has been in existence since 2001, and the Panama City Fire Department has been very involved with them for fundraising purposes since then. For many years, the Panama City Fire Department has supported Camp Amigo through softball tournaments and the Red Lobster Takeover. Camp Amigo will be in our area again July 10th through the 16th. The fire department will host a very special fun day for the kids on July 13th. The day will include lunch and dinner at the Central Fire Station and a great time at Shipwreck Island. In 2015, the fire department set out on a new fundraising project for Camp Amigo, the 2016 Fully Involved Firefighter Calendar, featuring some of our fire department's best fit firefighters. I can report to you today that the project raised a total of approximately $11,500. The cost of the project was about approximately $4,700. And today we are presenting Rusty Roberts, president of the Children's Burn Camp in North Florida, with the proceeds raised from the Fully Involved Firefighters Calendar in the amount of $6,803.02. I'd like to invite the City Commission to join us as we present the check to Mr. Roberts.
Oh, that's beautiful. All right, man.
Sit down.
This is actually a check you can pull up to the pocket. Some of these are hard type checks.
The bounce to hurt someone.
On count.
Yeah. Kenny? Get in here somewhere.
John, you get up front.
Yeah.
I can stand way up here. I get
you all right?
You're right.
Yes, you're right. All right.
Good. All right. That's great. Thanks, guys.
Awesome. Thank you.
Great job.
Congratulations.
You thank you very much.
Thank the firemen. Thank you, guys. Thank you for all you do. That's awesome.
We'd love to do that.
Just send us an email message. Yes, sir.
Mr. Mayor and Councilman, I'm here as a private citizen. My name's James E. Carlisle, Sr., and I'm having a problem down there with the city marina.
Need the address.
It's Post Office Box 84, Panama City, Florida. It's one of the finest marinas that Captain Stan I know is here. And the problem is, during the daytime, the bathrooms are open. I've addressed this before about porta potties, and I know not to say that, but I'd like to make a suggestion. I don't see why the nighttime guard cannot open the public restrooms during the night for the people that use it, because a lot of the citizens are urinating on the deck after this beautiful restoration, and they don't understand that there's cameras down there. And to come down to go fishing and end up with a ticket, you know, I just wanted to make that suggestion. I don't see why the guards at night with a sign saying they could open the bathroom. Therefore, after the person uses or persons, they can inspect it and then lock it back up. That's what I just wanted to suggest.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Jeff, you look into that? All right. Thank you.
Anyone else? Okay, we'll move on. Mr. Zimmerman?
First item I have is a request to hold an attorney-client session pursuant to Section 286.011, Subsection 8 of Florida statutes to discuss and receive advice today concerning Royal American Construction, Inc. versus Panama City, Florida, case number, and the case number cited. The city has a lawsuit was filed against the city, and it concerns some change orders for marina construction, and I am asking and seeking your advice and would like to have an attorney-client session under the statute, which would be at the conclusion of the regular business today. This meeting will not close. It will not adjourn. It will close the public portion, and before we leave, the mayor will read a statement that it anticipates that the closed session would last 30 to 45 minutes. At the conclusion of the attorney-client session, the city commission would come back, reopen the public portion of the meeting, take any action, if any, that it desires based upon the subject matter of the lawsuit or the advice that it received during the public portion of the meeting. At the conclusion of that, that would be the last item on the agenda unless something else is included. So that's my request, is that we hold an attorney-client session at the conclusion of the regular agenda today.
Okay. Here, we need a motion.
I think it'd be appropriate.
I'd like to move.
Second.
Motion second. Any discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnick?
Yes, ma'am.
And with that, you've added the last item, which is come back at the regular, at the end of the attorney-client session, and you would come back here to consider taking any action.
Yes.
Okay. To the agenda.
Very good.
The next thing I have is consideration of resolution number 4122016.1, supporting the historical recreational use of Shell Island. The resolution, the title is a resolution in support of maintaining the historical recreational use of Shell Island and in opposition to the implementation of any additional regulation or management plan for the St. Andrews State Park contrary to the historical recreational use of Shell Island.
Before we go on, Mr. Zimmerman, I want to know, is there anybody here that wants to address the commission today about this issue? Okay, seeing no one, go ahead, sir.
Okay. The resolution's fairly self-explanatory, but it points out the importance to the tourism industry in the past, but in particular to the future, to Panama City, as it markets itself as a more quiet, passive recreational venue, and the proximity to Shell Island and to all the marinas here in Panama City is critical, that the island remain available for use by the boaters. And then it points out that it's the desire of the city commission, and this would be sent to the governor and the Department of Environmental Protection and to the park manager for St. Andrews State Park, is that the historic use of the island remain. The county commission adopted a similar resolution a couple weeks ago.
All right. Do I hear a motion on this resolution?
So moved, Mayor.
Second.
Any discussion?
Yeah, I just want to say is just that I think we're all supportive of this. We want our boaters, we want our people to go use the Shell Island like we've done for many years. And just the only encouragement is that we as citizens need to make sure that we protect our assets as well and make sure we clean the beaches, we protect the wildlife that's out there, and so that we don't have to maybe get state government to come in and do some heavy regulations to protect us. So we just need to police ourselves on maintaining the quality of that island that's out there. So I just
well
wanted
put.
To add that. Yeah.
Anyone else?
I want to say I think it's important that everybody be vigilant of the intrusion of both the state and potentially the federal government in some of these historic uses. Very quickly, if we don't stay on top of it, before you know it, you'll have zero access to everything that makes Panama City special and attracts folks to come here, and people want to live here. So I think this is a good first step for us, and we just need to be vigilant.
It's the fear of the unknown.
Yep. Yeah.
Okay. Any other comments? We have a motion and second. Call the roll.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Commissioner Katie?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnick?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm going to read it again. Resolution number 4122016.1. A resolution in support of maintaining the historical recreational use of Shell Island and in opposition to the implementation of any additional regulation or management plan for St. Andrews State Park contrary to the historical recreational use of Shell Island.
Very good.
And next we have an appointment to the Advisory Committee on Handicapped Concerns. Rhonda Lynch has expressed a desire to serve a one-year term. This will give us a full slate. Do I hear a motion on Rhonda?
Mr. Mayor, I make the motion on Ms. Rhonda.
Second?
Second.
Call the roll.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Commissioner Katie?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnick?
Yes. We have two, two things on the consent agenda. Does the commission want to address either one of those separately?
I'd like to talk about 8A.
8A if possible. Okay.
Yeah.
So do I hear a motion on 8B?
Move approval.
Okay. Second the motion.
Discussion. Call the roll.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Commissioner Katie?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnick?
Yes, ma'am.
Can we go ahead and approve the park and parade permits as well? That's under the consent agenda. Do we just do both of those, or just?
I think 8A's in this, but
we can park and parade.
Jeff, why wasn't it under consent? Why is it broken?
It is. It is.
It is under consent.
It's
under 8 and 9. 8 and 9 are both
consent. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Numbers 8A and they just broke out 8A and 8B because they're two separate items. But yeah. Technically, there were three.
Okay, because I thought it was different.
Move approval of the park and parade permits.
Second.
Discussion. Call the roll.
Commissioner Katie?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnick?
Yes, ma'am.
We're looking for a loop there.
All right, Mr. Rader?
Okay. Well, the only question I had, I'd like to ask our city manager, Mr. Brown, and I don't know what bleachers cost or how many people can sit on these bleachers, but we're having some events once in a while. We're having more things happen downtown in the marina and even in St. Andrews, and there's if these are no good anymore, that's the problem. If that's the problem, then just I'll stop it right now.
Yeah, these are outdated.
Okay.
We're going to purchase some new ones at the sports complex.
Okay.
The new soccer fields.
Okay.
We've actually, in some cases, have gotten away from transporting and moving around bleachers. Yeah. For city events, we're a little more okay with doing that.
Yeah.
But probably about 10 years ago or so,
I remember what you're going to say.
12 years ago, when President Bush came to town, mm-hmm. And so we lent.
Yeah, somebody fell off.
And somebody fell off. Yeah. Everybody got off the case except for the city, and we were left then.
I remember.
Paying out a claim to this gentleman.
I remember Mr. Hammonds and I talked about that, and you did too. I just wanted to make sure that if these are in bad shape, then that's fine.
Yes.
Because we're going to have some great events coming up where we're going to need bleachers, so I'm glad we're getting some. So just want to make sure. Thank you.
So I guess the Sheriff's Department is going to fix them when they get them because we're
getting
them.
I hope so.
Okay. Well, he's going to do them. I don't know.
I understand.
All right. Okay. I'll make the motion that we approve 8A.
All right.
Second motion.
Discussion. Yeah. Call the roll.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Commissioner Katie?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnick?
Yes, ma'am. Jeff?
Item number 10 is consideration of resolution 4122016.2, which amends the budget and awarding purchase of 6 CNG refuse collection trucks to Chastang's Bayou City Auto Car in the amount of $1,664,907. This will be 3 side loader trucks and 3 front loader trucks. They will all be using the compressed natural gas. We're purchasing these through an interlocal contract, cooperative purchasing agreement. Staff recommends approval of the purchase. The purchase exceeds the budget by $29,907. However, solid waste is able to cover that. Staff recommends approval of the budget amendment and the approval of the contract with Chastang's Bayou City Auto Car.
simultaneously, or do we need to do the budget amendment first?
No, we can do it all together.
All right. Hear a motion?
Move approval.
Second.
Discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnick?
Yes, ma'am.
Next, we have consideration.
Well, you've got to read the resolution.
Sorry.
That was slow today. Resolution number 4122016.2, a resolution providing for the amendment of the approved fiscal year 2015-16 budget for the City of Panama City, Florida, for the purchase of CNG refuge collection trucks.
All right, item 10B is consideration of project development agreement with Siemens Industries to conduct an energy audit of city facilities. If you remember back two meetings ago, you approved the Siemens Industries to do our energy conservation work. This agreement is doing that work. The reason why it's being brought back to you is if the off chance that the city decides not to go through with this after they do the energy audit, we agree to pay Siemens $180,000 for their work that they would have done up to that point. Staff doesn't anticipate that happening. The agreement also calls for that if Siemens goes through and does their energy audit and finds that there's not enough cost savings, that the agreement becomes null and we both walk away from it.
Okay. Move approval.
Second the motion.
Discussion.
How long will it take to complete the audit? And in terms of asking that question, are we have anything that's coming down the pipe that we're going to order lights or the fields or Harrison Avenue? So if they're doing an efficiency audit right now on what's there, but we're going to do some new lights, I mean, I just want to make sure that we're not doing audit on one thing and we're going to implement something else down the road.
No, we are. We've already had a preliminary meeting. It'll take us to about August. Or take them till about August to finally get all of this, all the information pulled. In our conversations with Siemens, staff has had with Siemens is that we've told them, look, certain things are off the table because we've already got money budgeted and we're going to go ahead and go through with them. In some cases and in other cases, we've talked about things that we want to do in the future and they've included some of those projects and will be included in that energy audit.
Okay.
Any other questions? Call the roll.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnick?
Yes, ma'am.
Next item is consideration of resolution 4122016.3, which grants an easement on Hanna Avenue to Florida Department of Transportation. This easement replaces the one we earlier granted to them on Stevens Avenue. They've changed their mind about where they're going to need to carry stormwater from their stormwater pond that's being constructed as part of the flyover project. Staff recommends approval of the resolution.
Hear a motion?
Make the motion, Matt, that we approve.
Second?
Second.
Discussion?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay. No, you're good. Well, Stevens Avenue, that's in my ward. Mm-hmm. And there's been...
Okay. No, this is down at St. Andrews.
Oh, there's two Stevens.
Yeah. So Stevens Drive is on yours.
Okay.
No, this is part of
Stevens
the flyover.
Stevens Drive, okay. Go ahead, Mike.
Commissioner Nicholson.
My question is they're Stevens. They're taking the stormwater pipe that was supposed to be placed on Stevens, and they're just moving it over a road. Is that my assumption? Is what they're doing? And I guess they're going to tear the road up, and just like they're going to do on Stevens. Can you fill me in just on?
Yeah, the DOT, the whole project was kind of an afterthought. It wasn't part of the initial flyover plans. When they came and added the pond, they initially wanted to run the stormwater down Stevens. After looking at Stevens, the limited right away, all the trees, the DOT thought it'd be best to go down Hanna. If you look at Hanna, the mobile home park and everything's been cleared out of there.
Right.
We have a few utilities down the street still. They don't serve anything. it's all around better fit for the DOT. And they would rather spend the extra money going down Hannah. It's a longer run than they would, I guess, disrupting everybody's life and the danger of such a tight fit on Stevens.
So they'll be putting it on the west side of Hannah, I guess, is where they're going to, I guess, where they're going to put it. That's where the trailer park was, on the west side of Hannah, to run down, because there's no property on the west side of Hannah.
I'm not sure exactly where. It'll fall within the right of way.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Any other questions? Call the roll.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnick?
Yes, ma'am.
The City Commission has adopted Resolution Number 412-2016.3, granting an easement on Hannah Avenue to Florida Department of Transportation.
10D is consideration of ranking of design build proposals for a new office lab building at the Millville Wastewater Treatment Plant and awarding contract to the top-ranked firm. On March 15th, the city received two design build proposals for the design and construction of a new office lab building at the Millville Wastewater Treatment Plant, with bids coming in at $164,874 and $178,776. On March 18th, a committee comprised of Matt Stanley, Chris Lightfoot, Neil Fravel, and Daryl Cronwell evaluated the proposals based on the criteria listed and ranked the firms as shown on the attached spreadsheet. The fiscal year 16 utilities budget includes money for this project. Staff recommends awarding the ranking of the proposals to be approved and a contract signed with Anderson Construction Company for $164,874.
Your motion?
Move approval.
Second.
Discussion?
After Matt's description of this problem during goal sessions, I don't see how we can vote against it.
Call the roll.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnick?
Yes, ma'am.
Next is consideration of entering into a two-year lease agreement with annual renewal options with Drew Station for rental space of office at 11 Harrison Avenue, Unit A. Total cost for the two-year lease and renovations is $47,000. The administration staff needs to be relocated due to the St. Andrews Wastewater Treatment Plant upgrade. Money was budgeted for construction of a new office. However, since our long-term plan is to bring all the department heads into City Hall, a short-term lease for office space is a more cost-effective solution. This actually prepays the first year's rent and a $1,500 deposit and the renovations. Staff recommends approval.
Okay. Your motion?
So moved.
Second.
Your second?
Second.
Discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnick?
Yes.
Next item is consideration of additional fee for Guatemala Engineering to provide post-design services on Jenks Avenue widening project. The original contract for the engineer covered only services through the bidding of the project. This will allow us additional services to be provided at an hourly rate for post-design work such as inspection, invoice review, change order negotiation, and plan revision. As shown on the attached proposals, the anticipated not to exceed amount for these services is $43,023.75, and there are adequate funds in the project for this amount. Recommend approval of the not to exceed amount of $43,023.75 to Guatemala to provide post-design activities on Jenks Avenue widening project.
Your motion?
Move approval.
Second motion.
Discussion?
Yeah, Jeff, do we have any idea when this project is scheduled to begin construction? I know that's a broad question there. Neil, okay, yeah, thank you.
It's out for bid right now. We had the pre-bid last week. In 2 weeks, we'll open the bids on it, bring those back to the commission.
Okay.
And assuming the bids go well and you all approve it, I would anticipate that they'll start this summer.
Good.
Actually, okay. Turn it out there.
That's good to know. Thank you. Thank you, Neil.
Okay, did we
Do we have a motion and second?
Yeah, motion and second. Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnicki?
Yes. This time, the City Commission will close the public portion of the meeting pursuant to Section 286.001, Paragraph 8, Florida Statutes, upon request of our city attorney to discuss and receive advice concerning a lawsuit that has been filed against the city, Florida Case Number 16000316CA. The persons attending the attorney-client session are myself, Commissioner Nichols, Commissioner Rader, Commissioner Cady, and Commissioner Brown. Also attending is City Manager Jeff Brown, City Attorney Nevin Zimmerman, and Special Counsel for the City, Cliff Higbee. There will also be a court reporter present to transcribe the attorney-client session. The anticipated length of the attorney-client session is estimated at 30 to 45 minutes. At the conclusion of the attorney-client session, the Commission will come back and reopen the public portion of the City Commission meeting and consider taking action, if any, concerning the subject matter of the litigation. Okay. Thank you for attending today. This time, the public meeting is reopened. Does the Commission wish to take any action after the attorney-client session? And if so, do I hear a motion?
Mayor, I'd like to make a motion that we move that the Panama City Commission rescind its prior action on March 8, 2016, when we accepted the recommendation of staff to approve two change orders to the Panama City Marina Civic Plaza and bulkhead repair projects previously awarded to L&R Contracting.
Second.
Any discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnicki?
Yes, ma'am. Is there anything else to come before us? Not. Public meeting is closed.